Over in the UK, the pound are currently down against the US dollar, as you can see this, as the UK government moves to suspend Parliament ahead of the October 31st Brexit deadline. And that's where we're going to begin today's drivers. That decision to suspend Parliament causing outrage among many lawmakers in the UK. They say the government is attempting to force a no-deal Brexit without giving them the chance to even debate it. Prime Minister Boris Johnson says that's not what he's doing.
There will be ample time on both sides of that crucial October the 17th summit, ample time in Parliament for MPs to debate the EU, to debate Brexit and all the other issues. Ample time.
Nick Robertson is outside the Houses of Parliament in London for us. Nick, great to have you with us. I called it earlier a constitutional outrage. That clearly one of the cries coming from the Remainer camp here. But just spell out what this decision does and why there are many members of Parliament here that are outraged about their ability now to try and prevent a no-deal Brexit here.
Yeah, you're right. The constitutional outrage accusations are coming from the Remain camp, but actually this is the Remain camp within Boris Johnson's own party. The other criticisms from within his own party are unprecedented, undemocratic. Without doubt, the battle lines on Brexit have been drawn deeper. Boris Johnson, if you will, sort of going to a much stronger, viewed as a war footing on this. What was became very clear yesterday with the meeting of the opposition was that they would move to block Boris Johnson's efforts at a potential for a no-deal Brexit once Parliament began session. And it seems very clear that he has reacted and responded to that. So the criticism from the Remainers within his own party, but from the opposition party, the language has been even stronger. It's being called a British coup, a coup against Parliament, or as somehow some in the Labour Party, opposition Labour Party, have responded. And the leader of the Labour Party spoke a little time ago, Jeremy Corbyn, outlining how he sees Boris Johnson's move and what his plans are to try to defeat it.
Suspending Parliament is not acceptable. It's not on. What the Prime Minister's doing is a sort of smash and grab on our democracy in order to force through a no-deal exit from the European Union. What's he so afraid of that he needs to suspend Parliament to prevent Parliament discussing these matters? So when Parliament does meet on his timetable very briefly next week, the first thing we'll do is attempt legislation to prevent what he's doing. And secondly, we'll challenge him on a motion of confidence at some point.
But what Boris Johnson's move does do is strengthen Boris Johnson's hand in his negotiations with the European Union. One of the things that, as you know, Julia, that undermined his predecessor, Theresa May, was a belief in Brussels that Parliament would block the sort of no-deal, the hardline Brexit path. Boris Johnson has certainly created the understanding, both in Britain and in Europe, that this is what he intends to do. But if Brussels was thinking that Parliament could stop him on that track, this move by Johnson now potentially will make them rethink that and that his threat is real. Does that actually mean that they're going to back down in their negotiation position at the moment, which is the withdrawal agreement as it stands, no changes? Boris Johnson, of course, demanding changes at the moment. The EU saying that this is a British matter. They are standing firm.
Absolutely, Nick. But in your first sentence there, you said war footing. And I couldn't agree more on your point about if you want to take the fight to the EU here, you've got to look like you mean it. And this is Boris Johnson, a classic Churchillian moment where he's like, do or die. And he said that about Brexit on the 31st of October. How restricted, though, is the timetable here for Parliament to perhaps come together to try and legislate to prevent a no-deal exit here? Because by my understanding, Parliament was only scheduled to be sitting of the 3 days of the total time that's going to be lost here anyway.
That's correct. So what Boris Johnson has now sort of scheduled in terms of the timetable that he's calling for will be a couple of days before the European Council meets. So whatever plan Boris Johnson has come up with and put to the European Union in the coming weeks about what a withdrawal deal could look like, a new one or the old one, there will be a couple of days going into that European Council session for Parliament to meet and discuss that. So no opportunity there really to do anything. And after the EU has made its decision on any changes Boris Johnson may have made to that withdrawal agreement, anything that they might like to go along with and support, or maybe just turn the whole thing down again, that leaves just a matter of days, about 5 days before that 31st of October a deadline for Parliament to react to what Boris Johnson has proposed, react to the European Union's response to that, and decide what to do. It is, as we've seen, the pace that Parliament works at is not a lot of time. So even a loss of a few days in percentage terms is being seen as significant. And I think you're absolutely right. Johnson sees this through the sort of Churchillian eyes. He has gone onto a war footing. The trenches are deeper, the anger is deeper, the bitterness is deeper, the division is getting bigger and stronger. And you hear in the background there a little bit of sort of public anger being expressed about all of this.
Yeah, absolutely. I just want to bring it back to the opposition parties here. I mean, Jeremy Corbyn there, again, not really being direct about the what next and what they can do. What's the likelihood that now, despite the discussions that we saw yesterday and their apparent inability or indecision over calling a confidence vote here, what are the options surrounding that perhaps too? Because perhaps that is a way here, if Boris Johnson did lose confidence, because this is the only thing that Parliament can agree on, to try and rule out a no-deal Brexit here, that perhaps this is a way forward. And if so, what will that then mean?
Well, Nigel Farage, leader of the Brexit Party, which is obviously a sort of a challenge to Boris Johnson on the right wing, if you will, that Johnson is very much aware of here with his latest manoeuvres as well, has said that Nigel Farage has said that he thinks that a vote of no confidence, that vote is more likely, that a general election is more likely. What we've heard from the Scottish National Party as well, who've called, you know, Johnson's moves outrageous, they've said that this makes it more likely that there would be a second independence referendum in Scotland. The disunity within Parliament as a whole, I suppose one can say, is greater. But can Corbyn galvanise all that opposition to Johnson, even though he has a weak position himself, to block him with legislation or a vote of no confidence? And yesterday the assessment was the vote of no confidence wasn't there. However, some Remain party members within Johnson's own party may now take a different view to what they had yesterday. Julia?
Yeah, Nick Robertson, thank you so much for breaking it down. What a mess, and the mess continues. Thank you for that.